Under Mayor Doyle's leadership, the city has worked to build partnerships throughout our community. The City of Beaverton's Community Vision Program is a great example. This year, the Vision Program has created a video highlighting successes that are happening throughout the city. Successes that truly reflect our community's bold vision.
I love Beaverton because of the people.
Beaverton is a very energetic and dynamic community.
It's a city that really cares about its citizens.
It has a lot of possibilities.
The city is just a lot of community involvement. It's just great.
It's safe. It's friendly.
It's a great place to live and work.
We're on the cusp of so many amazing things.
The people here, not only are they friendly, but they really care about the community.
The intent behind AVL is to find the closest appropriate unit to respond to the right location in as quick a time as possible, particularly in an emergency situation. The idea of shaving off some seconds might not seem like a big deal in general, but 45 seconds when you're in crisis, when it's the worst time of your life, it's a big deal.
Walton Valley Fire and Rescue does run 4 cars, so we wanted to have a smaller, more nimble resource that could respond to calls in the community. They actually handle about 7.2% of the total calls that Walton Valley Fire and Rescue responds to every year. It's refreshing to have a partner like the City of Beaverton to help us both achieve our goals.
The Creekside District Master Plan is funded by a grant that allows us to look at the district as a whole, but also look at it from the perspective of natural resources, the 3 creeks that are here, the housing opportunities that exist, and redevelopment opportunities, plus the transit system that's already here. Everything from, you know, creating Beaverton Creek as an urban amenity to parks and open space and recreational trails and improving downtown walkability. These are things that the community has asked for.
First Friday is an event that happens May through October. On Friday after work. The idea is to keep work open. Make it attractive for people to come down here. Make it fun. Have different events. It's been very successful.
I think one of the outcomes of this whole Beaverton Downtown Association is that businesses are coming together and the business owners are getting to know one another.
And the Enterprise Zone offers an incentive to businesses to locate here, whether they're expanding, so they're existing businesses, or new businesses wishing to locate here. It's an incentive that we didn't have, and now we do. And now that we have it in our toolbox, we really see ourselves competing in the greater market of economic development.
The LED lights were the result of a stimulus-funded project to install, I think, approximately 500 street lights and sight lights within the city. The nice thing about LED lights is they use anywhere from about 25 to 40% less electricity than current street lights, and they also provide a cleaner white light that has less shadows and actually makes pedestrians feel a lot safer.
This is our first facilities partnership with Boys and Girls Aid. They're one of the oldest child welfare agencies in the state of Oregon. The building's going to be the permanent home for the Transitional Living Program, which provides transitional housing to homeless youth between the ages of 18 and 21. So the local business community, as well as the residents, have been extremely supportive of this project. We are one of the communities with the highest rates of homelessness among youth throughout the state of Oregon. We're building up our infrastructure to serve those who are in need in a way that is going to be long-lasting and not just a one-time project.
A little over a year ago, we put together our first, we call it our neighborhood response team. These individuals can pick a problem in the community that's been a thorn in our side, and they can take a little bit of extra time and actually get to the bottom of the problem and actually solve it versus us having to go out repeatedly time after time. I think the common denominator is the fact that we're working with the community to solve problems.
This is a new section of the Fano Creek Regional Trail, a largely continuous 4.5 mile stretch that goes all the way from Garden Home Rec Center down to Tigard. It's a real pleasure for us as a park district to be able to improve the quality of life for the people who live here because we really care about them. They obviously support us in a big way, and that's one of the things that makes Beaverton great.
What a terrific example of how partnerships make us who we are. And now it's my pleasure to introduce Mark Gans. Mark is the CEO of Cambia Health Solutions, which is the parent company of Regents Blue Cross Blue Shield of Oregon. His organization has strong ties to this community, both as an employer and as an insurer. More than 200 of Cambia's employees live in Beaverton, and Regents insures slightly more than 14,000 Beaverton residents, which represents 15% of our city's population. In partnership with Beaverton companies like Research Fine Foods, Yakima Products, Digimark, and the Beaverton School District, Regents is committed to collaborating with its customers to improve employee health and reduce medical costs. Beyond his leadership at Cambia, Mark also sits on numerous boards, including those of Portland General Electric, U.S. Bank, the Oregon Business Council, and Jesuit High School. Mark was also the founding board chair of Greater Portland, Inc., a public-private regional economic development corporation that helps bring new businesses to the region while supporting those companies who are already here. Mark continues to serve on Greater Portland, Inc.'s board of directors alongside Mayor Denny Doyle. Please give a warm Beaverton welcome to Mark Gans.
Well, good evening, everybody. Thank you, Bill. I really do appreciate, and I'm deeply honored to have the opportunity to introduce Mayor Doyle. As Bill mentioned, our connection to this city is very strong. And personally, for my family, we live most of our life in Beaverton, although we're one of those border neighborhoods that is just outside of Beaverton. I literally look across Walker Road at Beaverton. But it's a pleasure to live out here. It's a pleasure to do business out here. And we're really, it's so many of our employees call it home. And so it's important. We do have the opportunity to work and serve many companies out here. And one of the things that we know about most of the companies that we serve is that they really mirror the values of the city. You know, they share a collaborative spirit, an innovative nature, and an appreciation for diversity. And this was especially true with one of our newest partner relationships, and that was with Research Fine Foods, a great Beaverton company. And we're so pleased and honored to be able to join their family and serve their employees here in Beaverton. And I know that Pat Reeser was up here last year. I think she's out here tonight enjoying this a lot more because she's sitting in the audience. And I was also told that don't try to compete with her because she's elegant and stylish, and no one has ever accused me of those two things. So what I know that I can do and need to do is really focus on a great son of Beaverton, and that is Denny. I got the chance to get to know Denny through the work that we did to create Greater Portland, Inc. And at the time that we started that work, it was the notion of having a regional public-private economic development organization was kind of a curiosity, but there was a lot of skepticism about it. And one of the things that I remember about Denny, and is true, and I think all of you who know him know this, is he's just an inveterate optimist. He sees, he always is looking forward and he always sees the possibilities. And he was a true leader in bringing in other mayors in the region, other leaders in the region, and saying, this is the time, this is the place to create this kind of an organization. And throughout the entire process, and it wasn't always easy to get to the beginning, the founding of the organization, he remained a vocal supporter And since we have created and now are operating the organization, he is one of its staunchest supporters and leaders. And almost, I mean, Denny, I'm not sure you've ever missed a meeting because if he's, one time he even flew all the way back from, I think, Washington, D.C. to be at the meeting and then had to fly off the next day to another meeting. He really believes in the power of regional collaboration. The other thing that I will say about Denny is he understands who voted for him. And he knows, and he is a real advocate for Beaverton. And one of the things we tried to create with Greater Portland Inc. was this notion of friendly competition, that we knew that if we created the right environment, that if Beaverton won the opportunity to serve to be the home for a company, and Hillsborough lost, that was still a win for everybody, or the other way around. But when you get to that point where there's this competition and a company is looking at one community within the region versus the other, there is a very good competitive spirit that needs to be part of that. You want to, at Beaverton, put your best foot forward and really go after it, and you want to beat Hillsborough, and you want to beat Wilsonville or others. I want you to know that he is a staunch competitor for Beaverton, but never at the expense of the other cities. I mean, he always keeps that sense of the region winning so that we can have a common voice and a common face to companies that are thinking about settling here. Before I ask him to come up on the dais, though, one thing that I've certainly observed is that there's a very important power behind Denny. He is a force of nature himself, for sure. But I think he wouldn't be as amazing and as optimistic and as forward-looking if he didn't have Ann at his side. And it has been a great pleasure for me personally to get to know Ann as I've gotten to know Denny. She is a true daughter of this city, and she works to encourage the community's growth day in and day out. And she supports the arts, she's improving the school system. All of those things are part of her dedication to creating a better Beaverton for her children and grandchildren. So I just wanted to recognize her sitting in the front row and congratulate you for all the good that you do for this city. So without further ado, it's my pleasure to introduce a man who has helped put Beaverton on the map, both regionally and nationally, making it clear that this city is open for business. I give you Mayor Denny Doyle.
Good luck. Thank you so much, Mark. Before I get into the meat of the subject tonight, I want to thank city staff for making this event happen. A lot of time and effort goes into this, and this is not in the script, but from the bottom of my heart and the rest of this city, thank you, wherever you may be, for making this happen tonight. So I'd like to hear a little round of applause to the staff who made this happen. Thank you. Well, thank you, Mark. It was very kind of you to take the time to join us tonight. And I know, as you mentioned, you live near Beaverton. So don't let me forget to leave you the very simple annexation forms and paperwork before you leave. So it truly does live one lot of the city. But Mayor Willie, doesn't time fly by fast? 4 years, we started to build a friendship between what I call the Twin Cities of Oregon, Beaverton and Hillsborough. It seems in a lot of ways that it passed in the blink of an eye, but it also comes on the heels of so many early mornings and late nights. And we made it. We certainly made it. Serving as your mayor, I've had the good fortune of meeting with leaders from all over the country. I hear mayors of large and small cities as they beam with pride about their community engagement efforts. Efforts where they talk about reaching out to 200 people to learn what direction their community should be taking. You can't imagine how they perk up when I tell them about the Beaverton Visioning Project and our commitment to public engagement. I then quietly slip in the number 5,000 people we talk to and watch their reactions. It's usually followed by, did you say 500? Or really 5,000? How'd y'all do that? You have to forgive me, but a number of my good friends are from the great southern part of the U.S., and their jaws just drop. It's actually kind of fun to watch it happen, and boy, do I play that one. Back in 1923, President Woodrow Wilson said, "You're not here to merely make a living. You're here to enable the world to live with greater vision, with a finer spirit of hope and achievement." This is exactly what our community is doing. We're building a strong foundation for generations to come. That's what Beaverton is good at, envisioning a brighter future and putting those visions into actions. I am so thankful to have residents and partners that care about their city and who are willing to lend a hand to make things better for all of us. For me and our dedicated city councilors, it starts and ends with our community. We are here to serve. The state of Beaverton is strong because we have exceptional leaders on our city council. Please help me thank them for the service, if you can see them because the lights are off. Council President Kate Arnold, Betty Bodie, Ian King, Mark Sansouci, and despite his age, the new kid on the block, Mark Fagan, our newest counselor. So if you could join me in a thank you. So counselors, we all do appreciate your tireless efforts to make Beaverton the best of Oregon. Yes, Mayor Bemis. And let's not forget our longest serving city councilor, Forrest Soth, who recently passed away. We truly miss you, Forrest, in so many ways. I'd also like to take a minute here to recognize the elected officials who joined us tonight. If you don't mind standing, and when you see somebody stand up, ask them at the end of the speech, not in the middle, what they do. These are fantastic people, and there's too many to name, but if you can stand up and give us an idea of who is here, come on. Presidents, counselors, board members, stand up. It's okay, Jerry. It's all right. Pete, you're here. Andy, Catherine, Pat Garrett. It's impossible beyond that with these eyes to see, but Dick Scouten, I think you're there. That's it. So thank you so much. Last spring, I know this is a newsflash, I was fortunate enough to be reelected for a second term, serving as your mayor. During my campaign, people would ask, what's the secret to Beaverton's success? I've always maintained, very simply, there are two things that make us strong. First, we have the most engaged citizens in Oregon. And second, we deeply value our partnerships. I can point to every success and show you how collaboration was critical in moving us forward together. People and organizations working together for a common good. This is simply my most prized possession as mayor. We get things done when we work together. I'd like to share a couple of examples of how collaboration has benefited your city. By the way, before I go on further, Friday afternoon I was at a speech with Mayor Willie, and our Vice President Joe Biden came out to talk to us, and he said, let's go these next 12 minutes, and we'll be done. Well, 57 minutes later, Joe finished. I will not be that long. So a couple examples. We've worked with Metro to bring South Cooper Mountain into the city with Metro. Metro approved adding 535 acres of the South Cooper Mountain area into Beaverton's urban growth boundary. This gives Beaverton room to expand, but it also helps another partner, our Beaverton School District, with its growing pains. As a city, we have worked hard with the private sector to spur economic development. Graymore's $60 million Progress Ridge development was another huge win for all of us. It complemented the residential investment that Polygon Northwest had already made in South Beaverton. Graymore's investment has brought many jobs to our community. We worked with J. Peter Corp and Company, 45 Degrees Central, and Lanphier Enterprises as they voluntarily annexed into the city. These well-respected long-term businesses represented nearly 100 additional acres of land, which helps grow Beaverton's assessed value and keeps your taxes down. A particular favorite of mine is we worked with our citizens and our special districts, all of them, to create our voter-approved $150 million urban renewal plan. Each and every one of these partners provided steadfast 100% support for this plan. We worked with our partners, the Tualatin Valley Gleaners and the Oregon Food Bank, to help feed the hungry. We worked with Homeplate, the Chamber of Commerce, and the last class from Leadership Beaverton on fundraising efforts to help our homeless youth. We worked with another nonprofit, Boys and Girls Aid, to transform a neglected apartment complex and turn it into a safe home for homeless youth. And I'm so excited about what's going to happen with that project. We've worked with our unions, twice negotiating two contracts that were fair and equitable to all. I've said it once, I'll say it again and again and again. We have outstanding public service right here in Beaverton. They do represent the best of Oregon. Of course, we've enjoyed other successes as well. We've continued the important work to brand Beaverton as a safe place to live, to work, and to raise a family. We have rebranded Beaverton as a business-friendly community. We have demonstrated how we're committed to supporting the businesses and the jobs that are already here. And we continue the critical work to recruit new businesses. During these past 4 years, I have talked to thousands of citizens, business owners, and community leaders. They simply tell me, shut off your cell phone. No, they simply tell me, stay the course and keep working collaboratively to solve our most pressing issues. This next term, I'm committed to doing just that. I mentioned before that we have a great staff. They continue to find federal and state grants to bolster our investments right here in Beaverton. In my first term, we received nearly $5 million in federal and state grants. And we're off to a great start in 2013 with more than $400,000 in state and federal grants already in hand this year. These funds will help us realize our community's bold vision for the future. No more sleeping in Beaverton. One project I am very, very proud of is our new Creekside District, a $1 million Department of Housing and Urban Development grant will support this work, which integrates affordable housing with efficient transportation, green infrastructure, and public amenities. The Creekside District will help begin to revitalize our downtown. Another area that I hear the public talking about is the responsiveness of our city government. We're not perfect, but we're trying as hard as we can. We continue to pay close attention to our core services. Our citizens simply care about filling potholes, and so do we. We maintain our streets, our water and sewer lines, and our overall infrastructure. These are our most important, basic, critical to livability and to business success assets that we have. We continually reinvest in the city's infrastructure through capital improvement dollars. And when it comes to being responsive, the dedicated men and women of our Public Works Department have raised the bar for the area. Listen to a few of these milestones from 2012. They installed more than 3,800 feet of new water line, planted nearly 450 trees and 1,250 native plants, upgraded 176 bike path lights to LEDs, resurfaced 55 streets. They have even supported our creek restoration partners, planting more than, this is not a mistake, 15,000 native trees and shrubs at 13 different sites, and that was 2013. Our goal is simply to improve our watershed and stream health as we feed the Tualatin River Basin. Our great staff is committed, deeply committed, to sustainable best practices. After we complete any job, we send comment cards to our residents to get their feedback. I have a bin. Sorry. I can't see. Oh, over here. Sorry. Yeah, there's about over 1,000 cards in here. So we'll pick one and hopefully we'll pick the right one to share with you. Okay. I got to read it first. Okay. All right, we'll go with this one. I'd like to read one, actually, from the band here. Your crew was very nice, worked fast, worked hard, were very helpful and extremely courteous and very tidy cleaning up. Great job. I won't disclose the name, but this is a phenomenon we get all the time at the city, and I've been thinking about renaming these compliment cards. The vast majority are truly very positive, and I'm very proud of the men and women who make that happen. And as we all know in elected life, residents will drop in. They'll call and they'll email, and they share their stories. Recently, two of our public works employees were in Costco on their lunch break and found a signed blank check on the ground. And that was a signed blank check. They hopped in their vehicle, cut lunch a little short, and hand-delivered the check to the resident. The woman, to say the least, was extremely shocked. She left an emotional voicemail thanking the two employees for their kindness and for going above and beyond duty. Now, you talk about a holiday story because this happened 2 weeks before the 25th of December. These are the moments that make our employees stand out. Our public works team keeps our city beautiful, and they take care of what we have, our investments. It's important that we keep them in good working order. They don't neglect them and risk having them fall into disrepair. Again, our residents do care about potholes. Beaverton cares about filling those potholes. We care about the basics. We're also a community that values strongly our arts and culture. One event that I'm especially proud of is our Beaverton International Celebration. This event was created in response to our community's vision. We heard loud and clear and often that our citizens expect that we honor our diversity. This cultural event would not have been possible without our strong partnership with Twelve Hills Park and Rec and the Beaverton Arts Commission. The event draws more than 35 community partners representing 20 different countries and regions from around the world. Now, in my 60s, isn't that really cool? That is what it's all about. So those who put that together, thank you so much. Each year, city events attract more than 40,000 people, and that simply is the size of a small city. These events bring our residents together and help build a stronger sense of community. Some of our most popular events, such as Flicks by the Fountain, and our annual tree lighting take place at City Park by the Beaverton City Library. Oh, I mentioned the library. Our Beaverton City Library is truly the crown jewel of our community. In Beaverton, we are blessed with a literate community. Our two libraries continue to astound me and many others with the number of residents that they serve. Our humble main library, now 11 years old, is the single busiest library in the state of Oregon. Think about that. Beaverton, 91,000 people. That's fantastic news. They circulate nearly 2.9 million items last year. And over the last year, our Murray Scholes branch saw the largest growth of any Washington County library, nearly 13% over the previous year. And they're already busting at the seams. When I ask residents what they appreciate about Beaverton, the answers are pretty darn consistent. They love our world-class libraries. They love our beloved farmers market. They love our great schools and beautiful parks. And they love that they feel very safe in their community. On a more solemn note, the recent tragedies at Clackamas Town Center and Connecticut, and subsequent other places since then, since the Connecticut event, have really hit home how important a well-trained public safety team really is. For more than 5 years, Beaverton has been recognized as one of the safest cities in the Northwest with populations over 75,000. Strong public safety is vital. It's instrumental. It's essential to the livability of any community. Each and every day, the brave women and men of the Beaverton Police Department work hard to keep us safe. And if you knew half of what they deal with and what they go through, and it's good you don't, because that means they're hitting it out of the park. So if you could help me join in thanking our police department for what they do. Gentlemen, I should have had you do this before we applauded, but if you're here, please stand up. Union reps, officers, police, and the men and women from other police departments, please join us. These are our local heroes. Heck, we have reinforcements from Gresham here tonight. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much. And as we move on to further work in my next term, there is still a lot to do. We have made progress in a forward direction, finally at the round. And in my second term, I will redouble my efforts to revitalize this area with the help of your city council. By working together, we will right the wrongs in the heart of Beaverton, restore people's confidence in investing in our community, and investing in the round in the areas nearby. This month, the city council voted to move the civic functions of City Hall to the round. City Hall will soon be in the heart, in the middle section of our urban life as we grow this to an 18-hour city. We have a great local partner, Portland developer SKB, joining with the city, ready to create that 18-hour core that the community vision has called for in this area. A mix of housing, public service, retail, commercial, restaurants, maybe a brew pub, transit hub, power plant production capabilities to produce clean power at a 99.5% use of power as to what comes out. What else could you ask for us to take us into this next century or the current century for this area? The community and business leaders supported this move of City Hall so that it could be a catalyst for redevelopment in the area. We are making it happen. This move should drive up property values, fuel urban renewal in the process, and encourage the private sector to invest in housing and jobs. I heard somebody saying, we're doing cartwheels now. We're gonna go forward with projects. Theodore Roosevelt once said, great thoughts speak only to the thoughtful mind, but great actions speak to all of mankind. We have and will continue to turn our thoughts into actions on behalf of all of us, on behalf of our region and our country and the world economy. Now that we've made our decision on a new location for City Hall, we're turning our energy 100% to a new and better public safety facility. You may have read last year's editorial in the Oregonian highlighting this issue. Beaverton needs a new public safety center that will remain standing after a catastrophic earthquake. Last summer, the Oregonian wrote about this very issue. The headline simply read, "Major earthquake in Oregon could be in the next 50 years. Infrastructure not ready." In Beaverton, we must be ready. Let's make sure our public safety building, housing our first and very critical responders, is not taken out by the disaster, so we can be there when you all need us the most. Sadly, we live in a dangerous world, and the recent tragedies around our nation are a powerful, shocking reminder that we can never take our security for granted. Our current police, emergency management, and court facilities have safety and security challenges, and I'm understating that. They deserve better. And most importantly, you deserve better. Now is the time to solve these issues. We have additional priorities as we plan for our future. I've directed our staff to update our comprehensive plan. Excitingly, this will merge the priorities from the Beaverton Community Vision, our Civic Plan, and our Urban Renewal Plan. We are also creating a concept and community plan for the South Cooper Mountain area. This land, new to the city, will provide between 4,000 and 5,000 new housing units for all of us, and it will continue to be an economic boon to the South Beaverton area. We must. It's essential to continue to find ways to create good jobs in Beaverton. However, as we build our economy, we must also never, ever forget that there are those around us who are not living the American dream. We must continue to focus on helping our homeless, our hungry, our seniors, and many others who are so vulnerable right now who live amongst us. These are vulnerable folks that deserve no less than our hands reaching out to help. We have more homeless students in Washington County than anywhere else in Oregon. Lincoln said many years ago, "You cannot escape the responsibility of tomorrow by evading it today." We can do better. We must do better. I've seen recent college graduates struggling to find a job. I've seen parents lose their jobs. I've seen neighbors lose their jobs and their homes. I've seen families turning to food banks who probably never thought in their wildest dreams they would be making that call. They have kids. I've seen many families turn to emergency health insurance, without health insurance rather, turn to emergency help, and they end up having to take their children to the emergency room because there were nowhere else for them to go. This puts great stress on these families as well as our healthcare providers. These families are our neighbors. They're your neighbors. They're my neighbors. They're council neighbors. In Beaverton, we are trying so hard to find solutions, and we are finding them. The city was recently awarded a $1.6 million CDC, and that's shorthand for Center for Disease Control, grant to partner with the likes, now listen to this list, Virginia Garcia Memorial Health Center, LifeWorks Northwest, Community Action Organization, Washington County Health and Human Services, Pacific University, and Washington County Disability, Aging, and Veteran Services. Never forget our men and women. And there's a smattering of the folks involved in this team. And it is quite the team. It is very unique. It's a pioneer effort you're going to read more about as we move forward. Senator Wyden and Congresswoman Bonamici congratulated us, the city, on playing a leadership role in this area. And I'll tell you, I was there and I couldn't have been prouder when Senator Wyden put it so simply but so profoundly that this partnership is placing Beaverton, this is quote, on the right side of history, end of quote. This project is the first of its kind and it is also supported by Governor Kitzhafer. Ultimately, it will result in better healthcare opportunities for some of our most vulnerable families. In 2013 and beyond, we'll continue to focus on creating good jobs, family wage jobs. We must find ways to nurture our economy. In December, Nike and the governor made headlines as Nike is going to continue to invest right here in Oregon, right here in our region. Nike leases more space inside Beaverton than any other company and recently became the largest private sector employer in the city of Beaverton. With their new expansion, right here in Oregon, right here in our region, we expect an additional 12,000 jobs by 2020. Swallow that. That's a number that is intriguing, to say the least. These actions reassure me that we, the Beaverton area, our region, are on a path towards a better tomorrow. There are more signs of hope. In the second quarter of 2012, Washington County wages have increased at the fastest rate in the nation, according to the Bureau of Labor Statistics. It was an 8.5% increase, was more than six times the national average for that time period. And Washington County's jobless rate fell to 6.8%, which I consider to be a significant drop from last year at the same time of 7.5%. Beaverton has stayed true to being open for business, supporting our large and our small businesses, and growing their jobs is simply critical for our future. One of our biggest successes was the recently approved by the state of an enterprise zone designation for our city. Since the designation was announced, Vernier, a local software technology company, has committed to a nearly $3 million expansion. This E-Zone is leading to new family wage jobs, and we're thankful that we got that designation. If we are to grow our economy, the private sector needs a city government that, as a partner, is responsive and nimble. It's truly a win-win for all of us. Still, we have work to do. Our citizens have said loud and clear that we must address cultural barriers in our city. Beaverton is one of the most diverse cities in Oregon, and I have made it a citywide priority to reach out and welcome our growing diverse populations. In my first term, in my first year, I created the Mayor's Diversity Task Force to help increase trust, to establish and improve communications between city programs, city government, and our diverse community groups. It's a slow process, but it's one we must do. As President Lyndon Baines Johnson said, we must throw open the doors of opportunity, but we also must equip our people, to walk through those doors. I've taken those words to heart for many reasons. Thanks to our city council, we have now funding in place for a cultural inclusion coordinator, say that fast five times, to reach out to our ethnic communities so we can strengthen our relationships and better understand the needs of everyone in our city. We can't wait for it to happen. We must do it now. In the aftermath of Superstorm Sandy and the devastating droughts hitting the heartland of our great nation, people are talking about the changing climate. This morning, Washington's new governor, Jay Inslee, spoke eloquently about climate change. He said, "As a parent and grandparent, I cannot consciously accept the dangers of climate change for my family or yours. We don't deny science in Washington, we embrace it. We do not follow technical innovation, we lead." I couldn't agree more. In Beaverton, we are also committed to reducing our carbon footprint. We are committed to greening our operations, and we must continue to encourage our residents and businesses to strive to be more sustainable. Last fall, our sustainability efforts were recognized as we won the respected 2012 Mayor's Climate Protection Award. It's an initiative sponsored by the U.S. Conference of Mayors, and last year was sought by more than 100 communities across this country. And we were once again designated by the Environmental Protection Agency as one of two Green Power Communities of the Year. We must continue to lead in sustainability. The consequences of a warmer planet demand that we take action. Franklin Delano Roosevelt said it perfectly. There are many ways of going forward, but only one way of standing still. This next term, your city will continue to move forward. Through our $1 million HUD grant, we will fund major planning efforts to design and implement key components of our civic plan. One of these components is improving Canyon Road, no chuckling, it can be done, with our strong partner ODOT, which is the Oregon Department of Transportation. A lot's going on, folks, and watch what's going to happen. This effort will take a hands-on approach with everybody involved in serious collaboration, and I'm seeing it happen. I am ready for the challenge. Your council is ready for the challenge. The state of your city is strong. And I am committed to keeping Beaverton moving towards a bright future. You deserve no less. None of us deserve no less, no matter how many hours it takes. In closing, I'd like to thank the Beaverton Committee for citizen involvement and the Beaverton Area Chamber of Commerce for supporting tonight's event. Both of you are terrific partners. But yeah, I'd like to also thank my wife, Ann, who was duly embarrassed by Mark. I know I'm paying for that one big time. Being married to a public official is not easy, and then throw in my basic me, it's even more difficult. My schedule would try the patience of any spouse in America. And Ann, you stood by me all these years, so I have a little gift for you. So if I can spot you in the dark here. So in closing, Beaverton has a bright future. It truly does. We are going to change. This is going to be an exciting year, 2013. Because Beaverton has a bright future due to the work of 5,000 folks who let us know where they wanted us to go. They shared their vision. And with your help, we will continue to build a better Beaverton. As I look around this beautiful auditorium, it was great hearing comments from people outside. Wow, this is fantastic. If you want to see good dance, if you want to see good performances, follow ACMA's schedule events. You will not be disappointed. We came with a dance recital, I guess you can't call them recitals anymore, dance performance. I thought I was watching people in their late 20s. This is a phenomenally talented staff with talented individuals, academically 100%. So please, if you have time, come support the arts here. Come support the arts at all of our high schools. So during the inauguration speech of a couple days ago, President Obama talked about the importance of good roads and quality infrastructure, known as potholes. He talked about the importance of education and good jobs. He said, and I quote, "Now, more than ever, we must do these things together as one nation and one people. In Beaverton, we must continue our collaborations and partnerships, continue building connections and strengthening our relationships, enhancing our quality of life. Let's continue to lend a hand to our most vulnerable citizens. We must continue to maintain our roads, sewer, water, and infrastructure. We must continue our commitment to sustainability, public safety, and our other citizen priorities. Let's continue to grow our regional partnerships, tearing down silos that have been there for a long time, so that our entire region will thrive in this new global economy. If we ignore this, we will perish as a region." Heed my words, we have to do this. And together we can. And let's continue to move Beaverton forward and build on our growing national reputation in so many areas. Most importantly, and quite simply and quite elegantly, let's continue to represent the best of Oregon. Thank you all so much and have a good, safe evening.